Back in January 2021, I made a video about a liquid metal battery technology that was being hailed as a potential market disruptor in the energy storage sector, unlike many of the other startup battery technologies that also claim to be game-changing market disruptors. This one did actually appear to be quite an interesting proposal for large utility-scale stationary energy storage. And the company that made it, Ambri Inc, based in Massachusetts, USA, boasted Bill Gates as their largest investor. So it looked like all we needed to do was just sit back and wait for the revolution to transform our electricity grids and accelerate the mass adoption of wind and solar power. We haven't seen much about Ambri in the mainstream media since then. And 18 months or so further down the road, quite a few of you good folks out there have been asking me what's happened to the company and whether the dream of cheap, safe, large-scale energy storage is still alive. So I thought it was about time we took another look. Hello, and welcome to Just Have a Think. The Ambri liquid metal battery was the brainchild of this guy. He's called Donald Sadaway, and he's a charismatic professor of materials chemistry at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. Sadaway has been working on the technology for more than a decade, since setting up the Liquid Metal Battery Corporation in 2010, using seed money he received from Gates. Since then, the company has overcome setbacks and disappointments that would have deterred lesser entrepreneurs from carrying on. But Donald and his colleagues were convinced they had something that could fundamentally work in principle and that could be scaled up if they could just find the optimum combination of materials and operating parameters. So let's just have a quick recap on how the liquid metal battery works. Two different elements, antimony, which melts at about 630 degrees Celsius, and an alloy of calcium, which has a melting point of more than 800 degrees, are combined with a solid electrolyte and put inside a sealed chamber insulated with a ceramic material. The whole thing is encased in a positively polarized stainless steel case with a negative terminal at the top. At room temperature, the internal elements are all in their solid states, and it's impossible for them to react with each other, which makes the batteries completely safe for transport. To initially charge up the system, the contents are heated to 500 degrees Celsius, at which point the metals and the salt electrolyte become a single molten mass. Then gravity separates them out according to their density. The antimony sinks, the molten salt stays in the middle, and the calcium alloy rises to the top. Antimony is much more electrically negative than the calcium alloy, so there's a potential difference or voltage between them. As the battery discharges, the calcium alloy breaks down into calcium ions and electrons. The ions move down to the antimony layer, and the electrons flow out through an external circuit to do some useful work. The result of the discharge phase is a completely homogeneous new alloy of antimony and calcium inside the battery, with the electrolyte sitting on the top. After that initial startup blast of energy to get things going after installation, the reaction generates its own heat, keeping the battery at optimum working temperature and eliminating the need for an external heat source. That means everything stays in a molten state, which eliminates problems like deformation and dendrite formation that electrochemical batteries tend to suffer from over time. To recharge the system, an electrical current is passed through the battery to reverse the reaction and place the calcium alloy and the antimony back in their original positions. Liquid metal batteries need to be worked hard, ideally being fully charged and discharged twice a day to maintain their constant high temperature. Under those conditions, Ambri claims an overall end-to-end efficiency of 80% and tens of thousands of cycles with negligible degradation or capacity fade. And that self-maintaining temperature means the batteries will work just as safely and effectively in very hot or very cold climates around the world. In May 2021, Ambri commenced a project with a company called TerraScale to provide 250 megawatt hours of liquid metal battery storage for their Energos data center out in Reno, Nevada, at the Tahoe-Reno Industrial Center, next to other existing data centers operated by Apple, Google, and Switch, and close to Tesla's Nevada Gigafactory. The Energos project will be developed over 10 years and will cover 1,497 hectares and include 500 megawatts of renewable power capacity generated on-site and distributed via a microgrid backed up by Ambri's technology. Ambri's chief commercial officer, Adam Briggs, said the Ambri systems are particularly well suited for the project's high desert operations, for shifting of its large amounts of renewable solar load, and for its grid system peak shaving capacity. In August 2021, AMBRY announced it had secured $144 million worth of funding from a group called Reliance New Energy Solar, with Bill Gates also chipping in a bit more of his own capital. The money was earmarked for the design and construction of high-volume manufacturing facilities in the US and around the world to meet what AMBRY sees as a growing demand from grid-scale energy storage markets and large industrial clients. Reliance New Energy Solar plan to work with AMBRY to build out a network of liquid metal battery storage across its facilities to secure a domestic source of energy for its supply chain. Reliance Chairman Mukesh Ambani said Reliance Industries sees this strategic partnership with AMBRY as an important step in its journey of achieving its decarbonisation goals. Our investment in AMBRY is part of our broader plan to develop the Dhirubhai Ambani Green Energy Giga Complex, which will be amongst the largest integrated renewable energy manufacturing facilities in the world and the epicentre of India's green economy movement. Since then, AMBRY's continued the search for new partners. In June 2022, the company secured a deal with an independent South African renewable energy provider called Earthwire. The contract will see AMBRY supply a battery system to serve a 300 megawatt, 1200 megawatt hour combined wind and solar powered generation site in the Eastern Cape, which will be the largest battery energy storage system in South Africa. As demand for energy in South Africa increases and the publicly owned electricity utility Eskom starts to decommission its coal generation fleet, AMBRY are well placed to support the introduction of renewable energy resources that can connect effectively and supply consistently into the South African national grid. AMBRY will begin shipping batteries for this project in 2024, with installation completed in 2026. Then in July 2022, AMBRY achieved a landmark accreditation when it received certification for UL 1973, which is the standard for batteries for use in stationary and motive auxiliary power applications. This is an important milestone for our company, said David Bradwell, Chief Technology Officer at AMBRY. It sends a strong and positive message to the market about the safety and resilience of our battery technology. That was followed by news just this month that AMBRY is now using some of the investment money from Reliance Industries to expand its manufacturing capability at a new facility in Milford, Massachusetts. The new facility, which AMBRY is calling its Innovation Hub, will enable the company to significantly broaden its manufacturing operations to cope with what looks to be some pretty rapid growth in the size and scope of its operation. The facility has a footprint of 140,000 square feet, which is more than triple the size of the current manufacturing facility. That'll allow for a production capacity of 200,000 battery cells per year, which AMBRY will start installing into customer systems in 2023. This exciting new step in commercialisation marks a major moment for our company and its future, said AMBRY's Adam Briggs. Expanding our operations makes it possible for us to continue to innovate and produce with the speed and the scale needed to deliver quality, cutting-edge products that meet the growing demands for safe and affordable, long-duration energy storage. It's all starting to sound a bit like a PR video sponsored by AMBRY themselves, isn't it? But you guys did ask for an update, so I'm just reporting what's happened since we last took a look at the company. And in this case, it really does look like there's been some positive progress. And just for full disclosure, I have absolutely no ties to AMBRY and no stake in their business, and no, this video is not sponsored by them either. So can you sink your retirement fund into AMBRY and join Bill Gates and the others as an investor? Well, apparently not just yet. AMBRY isn't available to retail investors right now because it's not currently traded on the public stock exchange, which means only venture capital funds or other major investors are able to invest. At the time of researching and writing for this video, there haven't been any IPO announcements for AMBRY, but with an energy storage market projected to be worth at least $50 billion by 2030, I'm sure it's only a matter of time before the lure of Wall Street proves impossible for the company to ignore. So what's your view? Do you think this liquid battery system has a promising future? Maybe you even work at AMBRY and you can give us a bit of additional insight. Either way, as always, the place to leave your thoughts is in the comment section below. That's it for this week though. A massive thank you, as always, to our fantastic Patreon supporters who keep these videos completely independent and ad-free. You can join them in getting exclusive extra content from me and having your say in future videos via monthly content polls or for about the price of a coffee each month by visiting patreon.com/justhaveathink. And of course, the easiest way you can support the channel via YouTube is by clicking that subscribe button and hitting the notification bell. It's completely free and dead easy to do. You just need to click on the little icon in the corner there or on that icon there. As always, thanks very much for watching. Have a great week and remember to just have a think. See you next week.